a poor situation showing offside. First, at the centre line, a player cannot be offside in her own half of the field. But when this centre half hits the ball, her left winger is over the line and ahead of the ball, with only two opponents between her and the goal line, and she is therefore offside. Here it is on the plan. The centre half passes to the left winger, who is over the centre line ahead of the ball, and there are only two opponents between her and the goal line, offside, and the umpire is on the centre line. Now, if the left winger stays in her own half until the centre half hits the ball, even though there are only two defence between her and the goal line, she will be onside. The umpire is on the centre line. This is the same thing during play. Secondly, a player cannot be offside if there are three or more of her opponents nearer their goal line than she is when the ball is hit. But here, there are only two opponents, so she is offside. And now to see it on the plan. The centre forward passes to the right winger, who has only two opponents between her and the goal line. To see this, the umpire is level with the third defence. However, if the right winger keeps back to accept a pass from the centre forward, there are three opponents between her and the goal line, and she is onside. And there is the umpire, level with the third defence. Thirdly, a player cannot be offside if she is behind the ball when it is hit. This player has beaten all the defence except two, and is going to pass to the right winger, who is ahead of the ball, and offside. And here it is again on the plan. The right winger has run on ahead of the ball into an offside position, and has only two defence between her and the goal line. And to see this, the umpire is level with the ball. A free hit is given. This time, the right winger stays behind the ball until it is hit. Here is the same thing on the plan. The right winger is now behind the ball when it is hit by the centre forward. Even though there are only two opponents between her and the goal line, she is still onside. And of course, the umpire is level with the ball. However, originally she was offside, so a free hit is given. Fourthly, a player may not gain an advantage from being in an offside position. This often happens in the circle. The centre forward shoots, and the goalkeeper clears, the left winger follows up, remains in an offside position, and then attempts to play the ball. Let's see this on the plan. Here is the left winger in an offside position. When the centre forward shoots, the left winger is penalised because she is gaining an advantage, and the umpire is in line with the third defence. But had that left winger attempted to get back behind the ball, a goal would have been allowed. Here it is on the plan. However, as the left winger was offside in the previous situation, a free hit is given. One of the difficulties in umpiring the offside rule is that the position of the attackers must be noted to see that they are not offside, whilst at the same time the players with the ball must be watched closely to detect fouls. The umpire tries to keep herself just onside to be able to make accurate decisions. fouls are not easy to detect, and the umpire must keep a sharp lookout for them. 6. A player may not raise any part of her stick above her shoulder when playing ball. 6 at the beginning of the stroke, 6 at the end of the stroke. Nor may she raise the handle of the stick above her shoulder level in stopping ball. Free hit. Back 6. A player may not use the rounded side of her stick. Free hit. Nor may she strike at or interfere with her opponent's stick in any way. Free hit. Or use her feet to stop the ball, like this. Or kick it forward. Nor may she use her foot to support her stick when tackled by an opponent. A player may use her hand to stop the ball. A ball in the air may be caught, but it must be blocked immediately. No advantage is allowed from pushing it forward, like this. Free hit. A penalty would be awarded for each of these fouls. Whatever the stream of the game, the umpire, and here she is on the far side, must be up for the play. Now to obstruction. No player may obstruct by placing herself between her opponent and the ball. This obstruction is a whole turn. This is a half turn. Her left arm and shoulder are obstructing her opponent. This is obstruction of the body. The white centre half is preventing the black centre forward from getting the ball. Third-party obstruction. The white centre-half obstructs the black centre-forward, while the white left tears the ball. Free hit. A player may not personally handle her opponent by roughly charging her off the ball. Nor may she push her opponent off the ball like this. A penalty corner. Penalty corner. All dangerous play, such as the goalkeeper kicking up into the faces of the forwards, must be penalized. A penalty corner. May not interfere in any way in the game unless her stick is in her hand. The goalkeeper has dropped her stick and is trying to kick the ball away. Penalty corner. The ball may not be undercut. Watch the angle of her stick as she hits the ball. And see how the ball rises dangerously. Let's see if again. Free hit. May not hit or pass the ball between her feet. It could happen with a bullet like this. Free hit. However, the goalkeeper has certain privileges inside the circle. She may kick the ball, but not when she is outside the circle. Free hit. In a shot at goal, the ball merely rebounds off her hand, she's not penalised, but she's not allowed to play the ball with her hand or throw it. A penalty corner is the one who's going to defend the fouls in the circle. The penalty corner is taken, now temporarily checked by the defence. But soon the attack is resumed from which the goal is scored. Other penalties are awarded for fouling. This left half, who is outside the circle, gets 6. And the free hit is given. The free hit must be taken on the spot where the foul occurred.
Perfect.
The ball must be stationary. It may not be scooped, but must be hit or pushed along the ground. All players, 5 yards away.
5 yards away?
If she misses, but does not miss 6, she may take it again. Now the free hit inside the circle. The centre forward kicks the ball, and it's a free hit to the defence. This time, it can be taken from any spot inside the circle. The right left back changes her mind and takes it further round. A more serious penalty is a penalty bully, given when a goal would most probably have been scored but for a foul. Here, the goalkeeper is kneeling on the ball in front of the goal. A penalty bully is given. And the umpire strides out the 5 yards from the goal line. Now for a similar situation. You see, it need not be the goalkeeper who fouls. Here, this defender in the goal hits the ball out with her stick above her shoulder, and she must take the penalty bully. The umpire places the ball 5 yards from the centre of the goal. Let's go back to the penalty bully given against the goalkeeper. All the other players must be beyond the 25-yard line and remain there. The players are coming in, so it must be taken again. And if the ball goes off the defender over the back line, the bully must be taken again. This time, the forward pass goes, and it's the centre bully. But it could have finished like this. I'm hit outside the circle by the defender or the attacker. Then the game starts again, with the centre bully on the 25-yard line. If the ball fouls like this, the penalty bully is over, and the game is started again with a centre 25 yards bully. Or if the defender fouls, the umpire awards a goal. The goalkeeper is not allowed any privileges as a penalty bully, so she can't kick. When the umpire has had some experience, she can learn to use the advantage rule. And here are two examples of the umpire holding the whistle. The black right back hits the ball across the field. The white half rushes in with the set, misses the ball and gives six. But because the ball goes to the black left inner, the umpire does not penalize six. She holds her whistle. In the circle, this defender kicks the ball to a forward who shoots. So the umpire holds the whistle, and it's a goal. Before the umpire time, it can be seen at the international match. It's faster and more open. It's the second half of the match with England attacking from the left. And now as we watch the play, let's concentrate on the role of the umpire. Our game where the goalkeeper was kneeling on the ball and the umpire had given the penalty bully. She whistles, looks at her watch, and notices it is time, but in these circumstances, extra time must be allowed to finish that penalty bully. Blows for time. The umpire gives a very real service by applying the rules fairly and helping the players to enjoy the game. In return, she gets plenty of exercise, good companionship, and great satisfaction from the part she plays. As the players leave the field, they thank the two umpires who meet and compare scorecards. As one would expect, their cards agree, but then really fit people are always on the top of their jobs. That's why thousands of leading athletes of all kinds make Ovaltine a daily habit. You see, Ovaltine is a perfectly balanced beverage containing all the essential ingredients of a complete diet. Made from nature's finest foods, malt, milk, eggs, with added vitamins, Ovaltine can indeed be called the champion's drink.